Hi guys, my name is Michelle and I create hair, makeup and lifestyle content here on YouTube. Today we're going to be talking about the Ashpa leave-in conditioner and we're going to review it. I have been using this leave-in conditioner for 2 months now and I have 2B hyperosity hair. In this video, you're also going to be hearing from my friend who has also been using this for the last 2 months. She has 3A hair, low to medium porosity, medium density as well. So in this review, you're going to get a very good idea of whether this product is going to suit you. You're going to get like a complete picture of what this product is going to do for you. And we keep things super honest on this channel. So if all of that sounds like something that would interest you, then keep watching. So, I'm not giving you a demo of the product today because I don't want this video to be unnecessarily long. But if you want to see how I use the product and the product in action, then you can check out my video on log. I'm going to leave that video up here. Alright, so I want to start by talking about some of the things that I loved about this product. Number one, it does not pill. Now, when you take a leave-in conditioner and you start emulsifying and you start your application, sometimes praying hands will not be sufficient because you'll notice that the product pills up and bunches up on your hair, which is when you have to go in with a comb to distribute the product evenly. Now, when you do that, obviously you're not going to get the thickest clumps, right? Because you're going in with a comb. However, with this product, you're not going to have any of that trouble. Praying hands is perfectly sufficient for you to distribute the product evenly and you will not have any problems. However, if you're using oil and gel with this product, what I would say is work in sections and each time you finish a section, wash your hands and then start on the next section. Alright, next point. This is a super light formulation. I would say it's like a level 2 to around a level 2.5. If you don't know how I categorize products and how I give them levels, then check this video out. I've explained it in detail. You won't have any trouble understanding what that means. So this is a level 2 to 2.5. Given the fact that this is a super light formulation, I see this leave-in conditioner working for a variety of different hair textures. So if you have low to medium porosity, I feel like this is light enough for you to enjoy. Wavy girls, low to medium porosity, you will absolutely love this product. Whereas if you have type 3 hair, let's say you have medium porosity, then I would say layer this product with an oil and a gel and you should be fine. Wavy girls, if you have a problem with your leave-in conditioner weighing your hair down, then I feel like this is going to be the right choice for you. Because as I said, this is a super light formulation and it absolutely will not weigh your curls or your waves down. However, if you have high porosity hair, or if you have curls that are 3B or 3C and you need a little extra, you need a little more moisturization, then I would say that you can add an oil, add a cream and then go in with your gel. So basically what I'm saying is layer this product with another product. It works extremely well when you layer this product. The next thing that I absolutely love about this product is that a little bit goes a long way. I'm gonna leave exactly how much I use on the screen right here, along with how long I expect this bottle to last me, given how much I'm using each time I style. If you use a little extra of this product, you'll notice that it's dripping down your hair, so it doesn't foam per se. But if you use just a little extra, then automatically when you start squishing, you'll see that the product is leaving your hair. Which is what tells me that you honestly do not need too much of this. Which then brings me to my next point, that this product is going to last you a very, 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 very long time. I have been using this for 2 months now and I've hardly made a dent in the bottle. However, even though this product is going to last you for a very long time, on the bottle it says best before 12 months of opening. So the moment you open the bottle, make sure that you use it within a year and you don't hold on to this and hold on to this for many, many years. The next thing that I absolutely love about this product is the fragrance. It is super light, it is super mild, and it is extremely natural smelling. There is no added fragrance to this product, only whatever comes from the ingredients itself. And therefore, if you are super sensitive to fragrances, like I definitely am, my migraines get triggered massively by other leave-in conditioners, but I have not had that problem with this. In fact, every time I feel like I'm getting a migraine and I have a wash day, this is absolutely my go-to. Alright, so those were all of the things that I absolutely loved about the product. Now, let's talk about some of the things that I did not like about the product. Number one, moisture retention. If you have high porosity hair and your hair struggles to retain moisture during the week, and you're using just this leave-in conditioner and then you're using a gel, then this is not going to be sufficient for you to retain moisture in your hair for the entire week. You would definitely have to layer this leave-in conditioner either with a curl cream and then go in with a gel, or you would have to layer this with an oil and then go in with a gel. So what I mean to say is you would have to use log or LOC method and then style your hair. I've already shown you what the results are, and in fact I've even taken you throughout the week using this conditioner in my log video, so please check that out. I'll leave that in the description. Secondly, let's talk about shrinkage. If you're using this as your standalone leave-in conditioner and you're not layering it with a curl cream or an oil, then the shrinkage that you get will not be the best. Not to say that you're not going to get any shrinkage, you'll definitely get some shrinkage. But if you have high porosity hair, then my honest advice would be to use log method with this. And that is when you'll see that the shrinkage, the moisture retention is much, much, much better. Given the fact that this is such a lightweight product, it is going to do very, very well when you layer this product with other products. So I have high porosity 2B hair, and in this review I'm also going to include my friend's account. She has 3A hair, low to medium porosity. Now let's hear from Amrapali and see what she has to say about the product.
Telling you guys about how I felt since I have low to medium porosity hair. When I used it, I had about this long hair, a little above my shoulder. So I did not have to use too much of the product. I was not skeptical in using a lot of it because the consistency is pretty light. After 3 to 4 washes, I realized what the perfect amount for my hair was, which was about 3 coin size of the product on damp to wet hair, and style it normally with my Denman brush standing upright. It did not make my hair feel really heavy. It actually felt like I had no products applied at all. It gave me perfect ringlets. The clumps were amazing, and I would definitely want to use it again once my hair grows a little bit longer, which I'm hoping will be pretty soon. The moisture factor of it was pretty good as well. It made my hair feel soft. The clumps were not too frizzy. Gave me very less frizz, shiny clumps. But one thing I would like to mention is that the shrinkage was not as much as I expected it to be. Generally, my hair bounces back and it has a lot of shrinkage in it once I use a product. But for this, it did not have that much. It did not give me that much shrinkage. So yeah, very happy with the results. I would definitely want to use it again. So yeah, I hope this helps, and thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Amrapali, for giving us your opinion on the product. Guys, if you gained value from Amrapali's opinions, please don't forget to say thank you to her in the comments down below. Alright, so now it's time for me to break down the ingredients, and this is going to be super detailed, super descriptive, and super important for you to know. However, if ingredients are not your thing, then you can skip to the timestamp here. I would highly recommend you watch this section, because I promise you're gonna gain some value. And also, I have like a lot of notes on the ingredients here. I have obviously not memorized or ratta maroot these ingredients, and therefore I'm gonna be referring to my notes. Hopefully that's okay. So firstly, let's talk about the butter that is present in the formulation. The only butter that I see here is shea butter, ethyl esters, and those typically would suit high porosity hair. Now, let's talk about some of the oils present in the formulation. You have baobab seed and mongogo kernel oil. These would typically suit lower porosity hair. Next, you have argan oil, which suits medium porosity hair. I'm gonna leave the mnemonic here so that you remember what butters and what oils would typically suit your hair based on your porosity. I broke all of this down in my protein moisture series. That is a 5-part series where I broke down protein moisture balance and I broke down ingredients as well. Guys, if you have not watched that video, then I would say please, please, please watch those videos. You will gain so much value. It'll also help you to understand why certain products suit your hair and certain products typically don't. So for medium porosity here, we have argan oil. We also have sunflower seed oil here, which suits low, medium, and high porosity hair. Now, let's talk about the humectants that we have in the product. So, you have ethyl oxyglycerin, which is a humectant here. What a humectant does is it brings the hydration from the atmosphere and aids in moisturization of the hair. Under humectants, we also have a special category which is called film-forming humectants. So, I broke down film-forming humectants in my humectants video. I'm gonna leave it up here. Listen guys, that is a must-watch video if you're trying to understand how to retain moisture in your hair and also if you have low porosity hair. So, essentially, in short, low porosity hair is where the cuticle is shut, right? Which is why it's very difficult for the moisture to go in. Now, what a film-forming humectant is going to do is, it is going to form a film around the hair, right? So let's say this is the hair. It is going to form a film around the hair and it also has nooks and crannies. And it is going to trap water, it is going to trap moisture in the nooks and crannies. And therefore, if you have low porosity hair and you're struggling with the moisture being pushed into your hair, then a film forming humectant is key. And if you have high porosity hair where the cuticle is open, right? So if this is the hair, the cuticle is open and therefore it is very easy for moisture to go in and to also be lost by the hair. What this is going to do is it is obviously going to hold the moisture in and around itself, also in the nooks and crannies. And it is also going to form a film. And so it is going to help in moisture retention if you have high porosity hair, because it is going to, number one, form a film. So for the moisture to then escape from the hair, it is going to have to pass through the film. And that obviously is difficult because now for the moisture to be lost, it has to move and permeate the film formed by the humectant itself. And therefore, these are key when it comes to high porosity hair. I have broken all of these down. I've also given you a list of film forming humectants in my humectants video. So I would highly recommend you watch those videos. So the film forming humectants in the formulation would be nettle seed extract, aloe vera, panthenol, which is vitamin B5, and also guar. Now, this formulation also has an emollient. I've broken down occlusives, emollients, and humectants in my Busting Curly Hair Myths video. Guys, that video is also super important to watch. I'm gonna leave it up here and also link down in the description. And so, the emollient present in the formulation is called propandiol. And this is something that typically substitutes propylene glycol in a formulation. Now let us talk about some of the proteins in the formulation. So over here it would be very important to note the difference between small, medium and large proteins. So a small protein is going to improve the hair's ability to hold on to moisture and it's also going to help with elasticity. I've broken all of this down in my proteins video. Please have a look here. This is going to swell up the hair and it is going to give you that appearance of volume and thickness. And a medium protein is going to bind and lubricate the hair, and if it's going to lubricate the hair, then obviously it's going to cause less breakage. And lastly, a large protein is going to fill in the gaps of the hair and it will also form a film around the hair. So this is also going to be key for moisture retention and also for low porosity hair, but when used in moderation. Now let's talk about some of the proteins that are there in the formulation. Number one, hydrolyzed quinoa. This is a medium to large protein. And it also has lemon fruit extract. Now I couldn't find exactly what size protein this is, but when I did some research, it said that the protein that is available in lemon fruit extract would help with the appearance of the thickness of the hair, and it's gonna help with the appearance of volume in the hair. And therefore, my guess would be that this would be a small protein. And the last protein in the formulation is arginine, and this is a small protein as well. Now let's have a look at some of the novel ingredients in the product. Number one, black cohosh root extract. This is very good for hair growth. Then you have mecha root extract, which is really good for hair growth and strength, and it also helps in improving hair thickness. Next, you have milk thistle seed extract, and this is really good for falling hair, so it's gonna help reduce hair fall. Then you have bilberry fruit or seed extract. This is very good for hair growth. You have sugarcane extract, which rejuvenates the hair follicle. And lastly, you have sugar maple extract. And these molecules are way smaller than water and therefore aids in the delivering of a host of nutrients to the hair. Alright, so those were the ingredients. Such a long, beautiful ingredient list. Some of these ingredients, in fact, all of these ingredients that I just spoke about are absolutely top-notch. So many benefits in this leave-in conditioner. However, I feel like we're getting a diversified portfolio. I wish we had like a concentrated, smaller portfolio. That way you'd get more benefit from the ingredients, and the ingredients are stellar. So if I had to have one complaint about this product ingredient wise, I really wish the ingredient list was a little shorter so that it was a little more concentrated. Because if I'm looking at the ingredient list here, the really, really nice, beautiful ingredients start at 6th place. So it's not in the top 5 ingredients on the list. No one can deny that this ingredient list is absolutely stellar. However, if I had to nitpick, it would be really nice to have a more concentrated portfolio. So, all in all, you can definitely see that the ingredient list is really diversified and definitely has something for everybody. So, whether you have low, medium, or high porosity hair, I feel like this is going to suit you. However, like I said, if you have high porosity hair, then I would say definitely use this in combination with an oil and you should be good. If you have low porosity hair and feel like everything weighs your curls down, then this is going to be the perfect choice for you. You are going to love the smell, you're going to love the formulation, and you're going to love the results. And so even though this is such an expensive product, I definitely feel like the ingredients justify the price, because as you can see, all of these ingredients are upper echelons. What you're getting is quality, and it is very difficult to deny that. All right guys, that was it. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and gained some value from it, then please don't forget to thumbs up this video and leave me a comment. These things really help me get my videos in front of more people. So if I have a lot of engagement, then YouTube starts pushing my videos, and I work so hard on my reviews and I work so hard on my content that I would love for you guys to support me, engage with me, come and talk to me in the comments. I always reply. All right, that was it. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and most importantly gained value from it. If you want to see more from me, then you can follow me on Instagram. All right, thank you so much for watching. My name is Michelle, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.